welcome. If you love Battle Royale but have always dreamed of being the one in control of all the gameplay decisions, get excited, because you will be learning how to create a zone war game mode right on your very own island. Pausing for excited scream. And okay, great. Now, if you happen to stumble upon this video and aren't quite sure what Zone Wars is, or even Battle Royale for that matter, no judgment. In Zone Wars, multiple players are placed in an arena together with the goal of being the last person standing in the storm center. You can make your game simple, or you can wreak total havoc. As always, your layout is important to how the game plays, but the most crucial element for this game mode is how you have the storms interact with players. The presence of a storm adds variety to gameplay and drives the flow of the action. For example, you could design your island to be a large, open area with minimal obstacles, so players have to rely on their combat skills and aim, all while they try and avoid damage from the storm. Or you could choose to build the entire island inside of a building and make storm damage an ever-present threat. Imagine what happens if all the players are being driven through halls and rooms to try and escape the damage. Chaos, confusion, confrontation, and other fun words! But no matter what kind of Zone War game you want to build, there are three important devices to be aware of. They are all located in your devices menu. The first two are the storm controller devices. As you can see here, there are both basic and advanced storm controllers. The main difference being, you can generate multiple storm phases with the advanced controller. The third device is an advanced storm beacon, which is used in conjunction with the advanced storm controller to customize each phase of the storm. With these devices, you will be able to control all aspects of your storms, which, in turn, will control how players move during gameplay. For example, using a basic storm controller, you could make a simple Zone Wars island with only one zone. You could also set your controller to start the storm a few seconds after the game begins. By creating your island this way, you will allow the players some time to gather resources and weapons before they fight their way towards the middle of a single storm. The players will then have a collapsing battlefield as they are all headed toward the same place, resulting in quick rounds. If you wanted to build on this, you could use an advanced storm controller and advanced storm beacons. The advanced storm controller works similarly to the default Battle Royale. If you are unfamiliar, 10 storm phases slowly become smaller and smaller until all remaining players fight over the last safe spot. You can make your map even more unique by using the custom setting for the storm phases. This will let you use up to 50 storm beacons around your island. You can use these settings to make areas vary in difficulty. Adjusting the storm's damage, shrink order, and shrink rate can change the overall strain of the game. You can design your island around these storm areas and move them to different locations to make the combat more fun for players or you. And if you're feeling particularly feisty, think about turning on the storm sickness setting on your storm controller. Players will now get even more damage from the storm. Creating a Zone War island that is both fun and functional will take a little bit of practice, but in no time, players will be flying in to experience the storm you have created.